Welcome to the spoken tutorial on Create Community and Sub-Community. In this tutorial, we will learn to create a community and sub-community, edit a community, authorize e-person as community administrator. This tutorial is recorded using Ubuntu Linux OS 18.04, DSpace version 6.3, and Firefox web browser. However, you may use any other web browser of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have installed DSpace 6.3 on your system. Tomcat service should be running. Administrator's authority in DSpace. If not, then go through the prerequisite tutorials on this website. This tutorial assumes that you have done the immediate previous tutorial assignment in this series. If not, please do so before proceeding ahead. The metadata and the image used in this tutorial is available in the code files link on this tutorial page. Please download and extract the file before practicing. Community is the highest level of the content hierarchy in DSpace. Communities consist of sub-communities and collections. Now, let us proceed to create a community. Open a web browser and go to the DSpace interface. Log in to DSpace with an administrator account. I will log in with the administrator account. We are now in the admin's My DSpace page. Click on the Browse tab in the navigation bar. Select Communities and Collections from the drop-down. Communities and Collections page opens up. To create a community, click on the Create Top-Level Community button in Admin Tools section. Create Community page opens up. It displays the community's metadata form. Communities are described using metadata elements. Basic metadata elements of communities are community name, short description, introductory text, copyright text, sidebar text, and logo. Switch to DSpace. Now we will fill the community's metadata. Notice that all the fields in the form are optional, but it is recommended to enter at least a community name. Otherwise, an untitled community will be created. For ease of practice, we have provided community metadata in a text file. I will use the same for entering the community metadata. Enter the name and introductory text as shown. You can use basic HTML tags in the introductory text field. For now, I will leave the fields short description, copyright text, and sidebar text as empty. By clicking on the Create button at the bottom of the page, a community without logo is created. For this demonstration, let us upload a logo. To do so, click on the Upload a Logo button. We will be redirected to the Upload Logo page. Click on the Browse button. File upload window opens up. Browse and select the logo image from your machine. The same is available in the code files link. I have downloaded the logo image in the downloads directory in my machine. Then click on the open button. Immediately, the selected logo file name appears next to the browse button. PNG, JPEG, GIF format images can be used for community logo. Logo of any size can be used. Logo of size approximately 200 by 75 pixels makes a good visual appearance. Switch to DSpace. To upload a logo, click on the upload button at the bottom of the page. We are redirected to the Edit Community page. Edit Community page has details of the newly created community. The Create button on the Create Community page is used to save a newly created community. But if we upload a community logo, DSpace directly creates a community. In that case, it is not required to click the Create button on the Create Community page. We have now successfully created a community. Let us proceed to cross-verify the newly created community. To do that, click on the Home tab in the navigation bar. Then click on the Browse tab in the navigation bar. Select Communities and Collections from the drop-down. Communities and Collections interface opens up. Observe that the newly created community is displayed with a logo and name. Let us now proceed to edit the community. Click on the community name to select it for editing. The community homepage appears. Next to the community homepage section, we have admin tools. Admin tools are used for managing community. To edit a community, click on the Edit button in the Admin Tools. Edit Community page opens up with the details of the selected community. You can edit the fields in the community's metadata form now. I have edited introductory text as shown here. Once community's metadata is edited, click on the Update button at the bottom of the page. Notice that introductory text is now updated. Now let us proceed to learn how to delete the community. Click on the Edit button in Admin Tools. Click on the Delete This Community button above the Community Settings section. Immediately, we will be asked to confirm Delete Community action. To confirm, click on the Delete button. Once you click the Delete button, the community will be deleted. For this demonstration, I will not delete any community. So I will click on the Cancel button. We are back to the community homepage. Now, let us proceed to create the community administrator role for our community. We will assign the community administrator role to the e-person with the ID dspace.u2@gmail.com. Click on the Edit button in the Admin Tools. Communities Settings section has the settings for Community Administrator. Click on the Create button next to the Community Administrator label. We will be redirected to the Edit Group page. Observe that this Edit Group page is the one which we had used to create a group. That means, DSpace is creating a group of community administrators. By default, DSpace generates a name for the group. But we can provide our own name to the group of community administrators. For this demonstration, I will keep the default name as it is. Now, we will add the e-person as a community administrator. Click on the Select ePeople button below the ePerson Members field. Select ePeople pop-up window opens. Click on the Add button adjacent to the ID of the respective ePerson. I will select the user with the email ID dspace.u2@gmail.com. Immediately, the selected user will be added to the ePerson Members field. If you wish to add more members, then repeat the same steps. Once done, close the Select ePeople pop-up window by clicking on the Close button. We can also remove the member from the group. To do so, select the respective member to be removed from the ePerson Members field. Then click on the Remove Selected button below the ePerson Members field. I am skipping this step for this demonstration. Once done, click on the Update Group button at the bottom of the page to update the changes. So we have now successfully assigned the community administrator role to ePerson. Let us proceed to cross-verify the same. Click on the Content tab in the navigation bar Select Communities and Collections from the drop-down. Select the community. I am selecting the IITB Digital Library. The community homepage appears. Click on the Edit button in the Admin Tools. Now, click on the Edit button next to Community Administrators. We can see that ePerson has been assigned the Community Administrator's role. The Community Administrator has authority to manage the community. Now, let us proceed to create a sub-community. Hierarchically, sub-community is created under the community. To create a sub-community, first we have to select a community. Click on the Content tab in the navigation bar and select Communities and Collections from the drop-down. Select the community. I am selecting IITB Digital Library. Community homepage appears. Click on the button Create Sub-Community in the Admin Tools section. The Create Community page opens up. It contains the community's metadata form. Scan through the community's metadata form. The form is the same as the one which we use to create the community. Fill the community's metadata as shown here. For this demonstration, I will skip uploading a logo for the sub-community. Once the community metadata is entered, click on the Create button at the bottom of the page. The sub-community is created and the sub-community homepage is displayed. This means that we have successfully created a sub-community. Let us log out this user from the DSpace interface now. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learned to create a community and sub-community, edit a community, and authorize ePerson as community administrator. As an assignment, create another community with the name IITB Archives. Assign a community administrator to IITB Archives. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by MHRD, Government of India. DSpace Spoken Tutorial Series is funded by the National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. This script and the video for this tutorial was contributed by Pankaj Patil from IIT Bombay. And this is Nancy Vakki, along with the Spoken Tutorial team, signing off. Thanks for joining.